Hello, my name is Peter Button. I'm the Vice Secretary General of UPOV. I'd like to welcome you to this webinar on PLUTO, UPOV's plant variety database. As you will have seen from the announcement, we are making some changes to the PLUTO database in November of this year. And the purpose of this webinar is to inform you about those changes, but also to provide an opportunity for you to provide us with feedback on our plans. So why are we changing PLUTO at this time? Well, for several years, the PLUTO database has been maintained for us by our colleagues at the World Intellectual Property Organization, but now it is being transferred back to UPOV, and we need to have sufficient resources to be able to cover that work. And at the same time, we want to take this opportunity to invest in improving the PLUTO database for all users. So what are our plans? Well, our plans are that we will continue to offer a free service for the majority of users of the PLUTO database. So for example, the PLUTO database was originally created for users to search for variety denominations, and this service will still be available free of charge to all users. At the same time, however, we're going to introduce a new premium service with some new functions and options. But whether you're using the free service or the premium service, we're looking to improve the PLUTO database for all users. We're focusing on two areas. First of all, to help UPOV members that currently are not able to contribute data to our database, to find ways to help it, help them to make it easier to contribute data, but also for existing contributors to work with them to improve the quality of data. Now, I'm delighted to see that so many people from PVP offices have joined us. They are our data contributors. Please be reassured that we'll be contacting you separately to discuss the arrangements for this. But if you're already contributing data, there's no need to worry. Everything will carry on very smoothly for the future. In terms of today's webinar, I'm shortly going to pass over to Hens Mador, our IT officer, who will introduce a mock-up of the new version of the PLUTO database. With that, I welcome you to the webinar. I'm now going to pass on the role of presenter to my colleague, Hens Mador, our IT officer, who's been working on developing the new PLUTO database, and she's going to explain to you what these changes will involve. Hens, I pass to you, please.
Hello, good morning, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Hand Madur, I'm IT officer at UPOV, and as already mentioned, a new version for PLUTO will be released in the coming month. Today we will go through the new screens to give you a before taste of the functionality offered in the coming version. It is also an opportunity, as Peter said, to get your feedback in order to better fit your needs. Let's start our journey today. The agenda for today will be to go first through the term search, where we will present the standard and the advanced search screen. We'll do polls 1 and 2 and polls 3 and 4 in the middle. After that, we'll go through the elimination search screen. We'll present the PLUTO service options, the free service and the premium service. We'll do the fifth poll, and then we will open access to the questions, and finally the poll 6. This is how the standard term search will look like. This is the home page of PLUTO database. So actually, to go to the PLUTO database, you would need to authenticate using the WIPO account, as it is already the case. And then after that, you will be able to search for crops and species. And this can be done through this box. You can search by UPOV code, by botanical name, and also by common name. Then you can also select the authority. So you can select multiple authority or only one in this screen. And also you will be able to specify the record type as shown there. So for example, when you scroll over the record type, you will be able to see what the PBR, for example, will stand for. It will stand for plant breeder's right, and PLP will stand for plant patent, etc. Like national listing, also for national listing, PAT for patent, bill for bilateral agreement, and others. In this screen also, you will be able to define the date range from 2, and then you will be able to select one of the 4th type of dates: application date, grant registration date, submission date, and a grant registration end date. When you click on the search button, you will see the results. The results will be displayed in a form of table where we will get different information about UPOV code, authority type, botanical name, common name, application name, application number, grant date, and denomination. And in this screen also, you can see that you will be able to see the results and edit the search criteria. For the search criteria, when you click double click on each of those blue box items, you will be able to modify on the fly the different items you already selected in the previous screen. And then all this information will be displayed in a form of search sentence. You will also be able to do a lot of filtering based on different options like record type, denomination status, if it is approved, reject, proposed, published. You can also filter by end type, if it's already terminated, surrendered, or deleted. You can also search for priority authority, calculated expiry date itself, and the text field. In this screen also, you can see that you can save your search criteria. So once you made your search, you can save what you did, so that you will be able to reuse this information in when you access the system later on. And for that, you will be able to upload the existing search criteria directly. Also, you will be able to print results. And then this will be done based on your search criteria, and then the result will be downloadable in a PDF format. After that, I will show you the two new functionalities, download and get alerts, that will be available for the premium service. In both cases, it's also possible when you click on the row, you can see more information than the one displayed in the simple version. So, for example, in this example, you will be able to see the breeder's reference, the variety identifier, the variety denomination class, and the history of the denomination, when it was published, when it was approved and proposed, with the dates and with the denomination itself. In the premium service, you will be able to download your data. It's an unlimited amount of data that can be downloaded using this functionality. And also, you will be able to get alerts. It means that you will be able to receive notification of new records matching your criteria. For example, if you would like to know when a new authority, submitted a new contribution, so this also can be handled using this functionality. It's up to you to define the criteria that will allow you to receive email notification based on that. As for the free service, you will have also the possibility to see a detailed view of each record. So it's time now to present to you the advanced term search screen. So in this screen, when you click on advanced search, you will be able to see more options. So like you can select the time range, the date range for new types of dates, like calculated expiry date and expiry date. You can specify the priority authority. You can also select one or multiple end types. We can also filter by party name and then specify which party you are talking about, like applicant, breeder, title holders, maintainer, or other. And then also you can search for denomination, breeder's reference, and trade name using the same functionalities as what we have in the current PLUTO database. So contains a fuzzy starts and phonetic and exact match. And actually, if you want to have more options, you would need to go to the denomination search tab in order to be able to do a more sophisticated search operation. Another functionality, new functionality, is to allow also to search by text, by keyword. This text-based search will allow to search among all the data in PLUTO database. This can also be helpful for the user. This button is a floating button, and then it will go through the pages when you scroll into the page. So now we can we already seen the advanced search screen, and then we'll see how the display result will how the search result will be displayed. The same way as for the standard term search, you can see that actually you can edit your search criteria on the fly, the same using the same functionality. And then also what you can also get is really the search criteria will be displayed in the form of a sentence. The same way we'll be able to filter your data, and then the result will be displayed in the same format. You will always be able to save your search criteria, to upload your existing search criteria, and also to print results in a PDF format. In the premium service, you will also be able to download a limited amount of data and get the alerts. Now let's move to the other type of search, which is denomination search. In the screen, you can see that you can search by crop and species, the same way as what we have in the term search. You can search by botanical name, by common name, and by UPOV code. And you can insert either the denomination or breeder's reference or both. And you can select one or many of the available options there. So you have contains, starts, ends, fuzzy, and phonetic. And then the other extra question of option for this one is the similarity factor, which is the CPVU algorithm. When you click on search, you will get the results. And the screen is slightly different from the other one, the term search results, where you have different information about the relevance, the denomination, the botanical name, UPOV code, breeder's reference, application number, application date, authority, and the type. You can filter by record type, status, end type, authority, and priority authority. As for the term search, we will be able to edit on the fly in this screen your search criteria, and then the search sentence is displayed in a way that it is user-friendly for the user to get the search criteria displayed. The same way as the term search, we'll have the possibility for the premium service to download unlimited amount of data, and then also to get the alerts based on this search defined search criteria. So now let's go through as a wrap up through the Pluto service options, the free service and the premium service. So as you have already seen, so for the Pluto free service, you will be able to search and display results, to save and upload search criteria, to print results in a PDF format, in a very user-friendly format. And then for the Pluto premium service, so you will be able to search and display results, save and upload search criteria, print the results, have an unlimited data download, and also define and get alerts from your search criteria, predefined search criteria. This premium service is 750 Swiss franc per year, and then it's free for UPOV members, data contributors, and cases approved by UPOV members.
So thank you very much. And I don't know if you want to say a final closing word.
I would like to thank you all for your attendance. And then, as Peter said, please contact us at pluto@upov.int to make sure that we have your feedback. This is really important to make sure that we develop a tool which fits your needs. That's really the most important.
Okay, so there you go. We have hands ready to try and make sure that we meet all your needs in the new Pluto database. Thank you all. I look forward to seeing you all soon. Thank you very much.